So today we're going back on episode. Okay. We're going to check what it says. So I've already made a few characters. Anyone started binge watching shows? We didn't want to miss an episode. We've eaten nothing but pancakes. It's driving me nuts. I don't care. I want pancakes. Whatever. I've got stuff I need to catch up on. Like what? Do you have to know everything? You know what, Gerard? You need to stop treating me like this. I still love you and haven't treated you any different since the day you tried to break up with me. But lately, you've just been pushing me away and treating me like garbage. I'm sick of it. I'm sorry, but I've been having doubts. Doubts about what? Okay, I'm just saying. Okay! Okay. Because your carpet never stops working, there's Resolve Carpet Care. It lifts more dirt and pet hair versus vacuuming alone. Resolve Carpet Care with 5 times benefits. Question: are my teeth yellow? Have you tried the tissue test? Oh, yellow. What do you use? Crest White Strips. Crest 3D White Strips whiten 25 times better than a leading whitening toothpaste. I thought the tissue test.
Nancy and Christine believed that Kelly was having an affair while Kelly was married to their, what they describe as their best friend, Margaret, claim that has been denied. They say Margaret found out about the affair and was getting ready to kick Kelly out of their house. But instead, Margaret was found dead in the bathtub, and Nancy and Christine think Kelly killed her. You deny that?
Absolutely.
And you took a polygraph of Jack Tremarco.
Yes, I did.
How did that go, by the way? How did you find Mr. Tremarco?
Oh, an exceptional man. Exceptional man.
And the results are in this envelope. Would you like to know what they are?
Sure.
I have not seen what's in this envelope. Jack is a former FBI agent. He has conducted polygraphs for everybody, different government agencies, Homeland Security, FBI. He is a polygraph trainer, educator. He has the highest credentials that you could possibly have. You found him to be a gilt-edged professional?
Yes, sir, very professional.
Jack, did the test go well?
About midway through the exam, Kelly started to answer the question, did you kill Peggy? And did you kill your wife Peggy during August 2011? Emotion was getting involved in his answer, and he became more forceful in his no. And so I stopped things, I cautioned him about that. He acknowledged that he was doing that. And so we went to a silent nod test, which just simply means instead of answering verbally, he nodded very discreetly no or yes to the questions that were in the test format. That took care of that problem.
Okay, so you believe it was a valid result?
Absolutely.
All right, well, I'm going to find the result and read it, and you're okay with me doing that? The questions were, did you kill Peggy? Answered, no. Did you kill your wife, Peggy, during August 2011? Answered, no. The results of the polygraph were that the answers no to the two above questions revealed deception. So in other words, your findings were that Kelly was not telling the truth when he said he did not kill his wife.
That's exactly right.
That is your finding.
It is.
Was this a close call?
No.
How so?
With this particular format and this particular scoring system, Kelly would have needed a minus 4 or above to fail this test, and my final calculation was minus 15.
So it was not a close call?
It was not close.
Do you have confidence in your finding?
Absolute confidence.
Okay. And what do you say about that?
I find it hard to believe.
Well, but
when he was asking the question, did you kill your wife? I'm tired of being told I killed my wife. I did not kill my wife. I did not kill my wife. I had nothing to do with the death of my wife.
Does this polygraph suggest otherwise?
Sure. This is my second one. The other one I passed.
I knew Mr. Tumaco was the one to get. I've watched this show many a times.
Good
and
for
I knew
you.
It was
you
Mr.
know
Tumaco.
So much. Yeah.
And you know what? I trust that man.
Good.
And you know what? He called you out. You are what you are. You're a lawyer. You're a lawyer. And you killed him.
No, I didn't.
Okay, so who's tested with. If it came back that he was telling the truth.
Then you would walk away?
Absolutely not. I'd still continue. But you know what?
Yeah, she's going to continue.
But
what? Until I get a bullet in my head?
No, until you're in jail.
In jail.
All right, my final comments when we come back.
Sean, if we don't do anything, he's going to kill him.
The drama's been simmering all season long. Now, it's about to blow.
Word on the street to your baby daddy.
I can't wait to talk to your wife. To watch your whole family crumble around you. That's the right.
How you guys doing?
I'm going to protect.
Only one more episode before the bombshell-filled mid-season finale. Tyler Perry's If Loving You Is Wrong, Tuesdays, 9, 8 Central. Catch up with Watch On and On Demand.
JCPenney's Power Petty Days are back. This Friday through Sunday, find summer must-haves, like towels for $5, men's shorts for $9, and swim separates $15. And Saturday, come early for our 10 off $10 ultimate coupon giveaway. Hurry, sale ends Sunday. That's getting your pennies worth.
Two kids barked in class today. It was so gross.
Lysol disinfectant spray kills 99.9% of bacteria, even those that cause stomach bugs. One more way you've got what it takes to protect.
Come on.
Dogs just won't quit. Neither does Frontline Gold. Its triple action formula is relentless at killing fleas and ticks for a full 30 days.
Good boy.
Go for the gold.
I struggle with bipolar depression, and it's tough. It leaves me feeling sad and empty, and that makes it hard to be there for the people I love. So I talk to my doctor, and she prescribes Latuda.
There are many forms of depression.
severe part of life's low moments. And that means so much to me.
Ask your doctor if once daily Latuda is right for you. Pay as little as a $15 copay. Visit Latuda.com.
Introducing Applebee's Big Bold Grill Combos with perfect pairings like our generous half rack of ribs and savory grilled chicken. Enjoy two grilled favorites with your choice of two sides like unlimited fries, all from just $12.99. Only at Applebee's.
Every day we are called to duty, ambushed, outflanked, and surrounded. What if there was a place to declare peace? The all-new Serta Perfect Sleeper, the most comfortable place to declare peace.
My dad, he was shot and killed.
You're black, you're a male. How did that make you feel? She stole his car.
That is a felony.
What I just saw really bothered me.
I think she's going Old Testament.
The Book of John Gray, Saturday, 10, 9 Central.
Well, today we've been talking about a very impassioned dispute between the very dear friends of someone that believes that their friend has lost their life through foul play. And they are on a mission, they are impassioned, and you may be in a similar situation. But let me tell you something. I am a strong believer.
Popular breed of dog in the world.
They are adaptable dogs that will fit in many circumstances.
They were bred to be swimmers. In fact, a lab's webbed feet propel it faster through the water than a duck's propel it. Koalas are the smallest breed of all. The AKC says they should be under 6 pounds. They're the oldest breed from North America and probably related to a fox. They're so childlike, they even have a soft spot on their head, like babies. Bred as a water retriever, the poodle is now thought of as more of a companion dog. But those fancy clip jobs were really meant to keep the poodle warm in water. They come in 3 sizes. And they remain one of the most successful breeds of all time. Remember, every dog is an individual, and can vary from the general breed characteristics for temperament, health, and adaptability. If you're adopting a dog, do your homework. A dog can be a wonderful addition to your life. Choose your next best friend wisely.
Michael is the one that's
going to
be running after the cat.
Oh my gosh, what's happening?
Thank you. change a little.
Okay, so now that there's a bit of a problem there. Michael and Chris are displaying that classic good cop, bad cop behavior, where Chris is the one who pets the cat and loves the cat, where Michael is making sure that this cat doesn't die. He's actually the guardian. What Chris is, I have no idea. What have you tried to keep him in?
I try to overfeed
him.
To overfeed him.
So he's too full to move?
Yeah.
Cat likes potato chips.
No, that's a good idea.
As serious, you would not
play
be.
Together and watch TV and they're both eating chips.
So you're hoping that that's going to keep him running out of the house. I'm going to die.
Cats are what we call obligate carnivores. That means that they're only supposed to eat meat. They're not chocobores and they're not chipobores. As a matter of fact, there are certain types of chocolate in certain quantities that can kill your cats.
This was our bedroom.
Okay. So now in here, I kind of smell pee. Right?
It's probably that.
Hides in the corner and pisses out all our clothes in the drawers.
Is it somebody's clothes that gets hit more than others?
Mine usually always.
Does he pee on your bed?
He does pee on his bed.
Yeah, he's peeing on my bed. As Michael and Chris were pointing out all the spots that Kitty had peed, well, you can't see them. But you can sure smell them. You can smell it everywhere in their room. I'm just going to go around here and look for pee. So it was time for me to get my black light out and go around the room.
Oh.
I wanted to find a spot that they didn't even know about. So it's this side of the bed that he tends to go on, right? That's yours? So there you have something there. He definitely peed this up quite a bit, actually. So there's a bunch of pee dripping down.
Oh my God.
All the way down to the floor, kind of. Again, it is very much your side of things. Well, I got all the information that I needed from the space itself in this territory.
Hi!
But now, it's kind of my favorite time. I get to spend some one-on-one time with Kitty.
What is this?
What is that? Oh. Oh my God, you're the biggest playhound ever. Watching Kitty play with that toy, I knew that he had never been played with like this before. He had never had an interactive toy. He knew how to hunt. It was jackpot beyond anything he had ever known before. And it was great to bring that to his life. I felt like Santa Claus. Hey, guys.
Hey, it's Hanukkah.
Well, it was fun.
What happened?
Really? He's a lot of fun.
Really?
I mean, first of all, he's just a normal teenage boy. So I'm going to give you really concrete homework. The first thing is, tomorrow, we got to get this guy set up and then get Kitty neutered. What's that?
I feel bad for him.
He's an unneutered Tom at a year old. This is his only job in the whole world, is to make more little kitties and mark his territory. If he remains intact and he's not allowed outside, he's going to become destructive in the house by making a mess and peeing all over the place. Now, here's the second part. It's going to be fun for one of you guys anyway. We're going to switch roles. Good cop, bad cop, bad cop, good cop. That means no more discipline from you, no more cleaning, no more scooping. Your only job is to learn what makes him move around the house. I'm going to leave you with one of the toys that I work with. You go crazy with, you play with it, and getting tired. That's the kind of energy that you want to expend so he's not going out there looking for fun, right? And there he gets that full range of experience that all comes from you.
Not it.
From you. Okay? Just for the next couple weeks.
This is great.
Now that also means if you got to chase him up a tree, if you got to get him out from under a car, you're going to be the one chasing him outside. You're going to be the one scooping the litter boxes. You're going to be the one cleaning up pee and poo. And you start giving him his food. It's not good for your relationship if you're the only one doing everything and all the resentment that comes from that, and then you guys start fighting about the weather. All right. It was really great meeting you.
Great meeting you. If Kitty continues to misbehave,
I will talk to you guys really soon.
If Jackson can't help me with the cat, then we really need to give him away.
Start with
Kelly's diet, I was surprised by the price of his new food. Then I found Chewy.com. With Chewy, I save on food, treats, and litter. Even shipping is free. There's no reason for me to shop anywhere else. Save 20% on your favorite brands and get fast, free shipping. Shop online at Chewy.com.
Showed up, it was not like the first time at all.
I mean, just like, what's up, Jackson?
Tell me what's happened to him.
He's peed one time deliberately.
Oh, really?
But he hasn't had that fighting, like, desire.
Like, I gotta get out of here.
Get out of this house, like you were saying.
But there's not that biological imperative to go out there and copulate. What you gonna do?
Come home.
Come home and eat. Yeah, exactly. So Michael seems relaxed. Everything seems fine. Now Chris, something is definitely not feeling right with her. This is a weird vibe coming off of her.
So do you resent the fact that you're scooping litter boxes?
When we first met, you kept talking about how it was a man's job.
I still think it's a man's job. You don't see women like digging holes with shovels. You know what I mean?
Wait.
but I mean maybe not you, but
maybe not as much.
But here's the thing that I fear that, like, I'm going to walk out of here, and as soon as I walk out of here, you're gonna be like, I'm done. I mean, if you guys don't come to some kind of sustainable agreement about what jobs get done, then Kitty will be responsible for you guys going off on each other.
I think Chris can keep up doing the work for a week.
Tell me about the trip to the
deck. No,
okay.
I took the cat to the deck.
How does that work? You were supposed to be the backup. You're supposed to do that. I find that completely wrong, unacceptable to put it in Michael's lap. This is a big thing with the cat's life. You want to be a guardian, you want to be an advocate, act like it.
I took Kitty, and the other thing I had a problem with was they wanted to put a chip with Kitty. I wouldn't want to chip myself, so why put it in
my... It doesn't put out anything, it's just yes. It's a nerve.
It's not a frequency, it's
just... No, it's nothing. Like a barcode. A routine part of getting your cat spayed or neutered is also getting them microchipped. It's accepted practice now. It's a way to get cats home if they get lost.
Well, I wasn't sure what she was going to think either about the chip.
Well, which would have been soft if you were there. You seem very calm about this, but this was the position that you were in from the day I met you, which was that you were on the hook for things. Well, Chris gets off the hook. I'm sorry to say this, because you weren't there. You could have made the appointment with both of you. You could have been there. Your specific directions for me was for you to be the person to go. And he's like, I would be fine if you didn't go. I'm not fine that you didn't go. So the problem is that Michael gets to be the one who gets to get resentful because he's sitting there getting lectured by the vet to make these decisions without talking to Chris.
When Jackson was giving her little taste of medicine that I have to deal with, I've been just like,
enjoying it.
Go Jackson.
Come on.
Someone's gonna stick up for me.
Kind of vengeful.
No, not vengeful.
Yeah.
Okay. Last time we were here, we had some major issues.
Oh, hello. There is a bunch of Peter being here.
Oh my god. Since the neutering, one time.
Right.
Now, on a bigger note, the fact is it's only happened one time.
One time.
It happened right after he got neutered, which means it's more biological than it is a choice. Kitty's not peeing in the house anymore because Kitty got neutered. And without his testosterone running his life, he doesn't feel that need to territorially mark every piece of the house anymore. Now, who cleaned up that pee?
Me.
You did?
Yeah.
He did.
Think I was gonna touch that?
Oh, no. Congratulations. No, seriously. You cleaned up pee, you're scooping, and you're feeding.
It definitely felt good that Jackson recognized the good job I've been doing cleaning up, especially after the hard time he gave me about the bed.
It's good to see you, buddy. Now, tell me, what's been going on with playtime with him?
Oh, he's great. Watch this.
Watch this.
He's just a...
Oh, hello.
He just loves it.
Hey, I'm gonna get out of the way. You play?
Yeah.
I wanna see you play with him. And now you're doing this with him every day?
Yeah. He's just so happy.
Yeah. That's great.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Good boy. Not only has Michael been playing with Kitty, but there's this element of investment. There's this element of fascination. And when people get fascinated with their cats, I know I got them. How is your feeding schedule right now?
I just give it to him whenever he doesn't have anything meals.
For your homework this time, I really want you guys to now get together. So what I want you to do, you continue your play with him, exhausted, then food. The only time he gets food is when this is happening. When this is done and he's exhausted, then we go for food.
Mm-hmm.
Cool?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go. If Chris wants to try being a responsible pet guardian, she can start by not just feeding Kitty the right foods, but feeding him at least 2 or 3 times a day. Try doing it after playtime in the morning and right before bedtime as well. By the time I get back here next time, I want you to come up with a sustainable model of how, going forward, you guys are predictably going to take care of things. This way we're getting rid of the resentment that you're doing everything in the world and you're not doing anything, or that you feel like you shouldn't be doing so much scooping and Michael should be doing more. Now the two of you can be doing the fun things together. Now, Chris, you have an extra little piece of homework this week.
Okay.
I want you to get him microchip.
Okay.
Good. So, it's been great.
Thank you so much.
Hey, you're totally welcome. We'll see you guys in a few weeks, all right?
See ya.
Take care.
Yeah.
Bye, guys. If they want success with kids, they better both step it up, both invest in the work, or it might as well be the end of kidding.
I was always the girl with psoriasis. People don't stare anymore.
I never joined in. That wasn't fair to any of us.
I was covered. I tried lots of things over the years.
But I didn't give up.
I kept on fighting.
I found something that worked.
That still works.
Now, see me.
See me.
I found clear skin that lasts.
See if Cosentyx can make a difference for you. Cosentyx has proven how warm water to severe plaque psoriasis find clear skin that can last. Don't use if you're allergic to Cosentyx. Before starting Cosentyx, you should be checked for tuberculosis. Increased risk of infections and lowered ability to fight them may occur. Tell your doctor if you have an infection or symptoms, or if you've received a vaccine or plan to. If you have inflammatory bowel disease, tell your doctor if symptoms develop or worsen. Serious allergic reactions may occur.
See me to know.
Clear skin can last.
Don't hold back. Ask your dermatologist if Cosentyx can help you find clear skin that lasts.
Finished.
You wouldn't want your finger to quit partway.
I think you missed a spot.
So when it comes to pain relievers, why put up with just part of a day? A leak. Leave hole, not part. You want this color over the whole house.
Come on.
Dogs just won't quit. Neither does Frontline Gold. Its triple action formula is relentless, and it cleans and ticks for a full 30 days. Go for the gold.
I love this show.
Poor Tom. Biggest star in Hollywood. The hardest Catalan. Yet no amount of laughter or praise can satisfy.
Oh, no. Well, right, I'm still on video. Okay. Did I hear them?
Tom has reached the pinnacle of success. But is this all there is?
Thomas, my number one star! Mr. Jefferson, here, we're gonna do it for you. Tom, you can't quit show business. You're a star, the biggest. Your public will never forgive you. Oh, forget them. I would never forgive you. And your thought won't work outside of Hollywood.
Simpler life really be so simple?
Good.
lot of work outside of home.
She's just in the camp viewpoint.
Sure is lonely, isn't it, Jerry?
Stephen, do you know what you're doing?
Whatever Homeworld has in store for me, I'm ready! I'm the one you're looking for!
Thank you.
Oh, it's coming.